Next type of chart that I want to represent is, it is a bar chart type only, but it is called as a stack column chart. Okay, why it is called as a stack column chart? Because here there are certain items which are summing to 100%. Okay, as an example, let's take example. It's here we have a sale of a company. It is across region over the years. So the company has demarcated its sales region as east, west, north, south. Okay. So if you see the sales of the company in all these areas, okay, it will sum to 100% of the sales. So what we want is, we want to get a view of how the company is doing over the years in all the category, in all the region, right? Which region is growing, which region is not growing, right? So you will get a clear understanding through this visualization that how the company is performing. Let's see how we can do. Note that this can be represented using pie chart for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, like that, but as we discussed that, okay, it would not give you a good idea about how things are moving. So it's better that we can represent this as a stack column chart. Note that this data could also be represented as stack column chart, that is how much percentage of the people are, let's say, so we can first see this. So we can represent this as a stack column chart. So what I have is, okay, so insert, then column, and then this is a third one, 100% stack column. Okay, this. Okay, yeah, this is the correct one. That I will. Okay, let's see. This one is a stack column chart. What we have is, we are saying that the sales are summing up to 100%. So 0% to 100%. Okay. And this is your years 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So maybe like for 5 years it may look crowded, but you can get an idea about. See, what is happening is this region, which is your east region, the percentage, as a percentage, east region has grown its sales. As a percentage, it has grown. As a percentage, west sales have also grown. Okay. So now see, east plus west, they are combinedly, they are making more than 50%. So this is a much better representation to see that how the various regions are performing. Right. Note that here there can be lots of things you can do. Let's say suppose if you want to know how the percentage is happening, so you can go to design and you can see the various type. Okay, sorry, you can see the types are, so here they have given you the, not the percentage, but the values. Okay, let's see. Not necessary. Okay, this is giving you a trend. See, if I remove this, see, this is giving you trend. So this has increased, then gone down, then increased, then increased. So this is giving you the trend. Now what you can do is, many places you will find that this, they do not want it the bold line. I can make it format. I can format, maybe I can make gradient line, whatever the line style you want to make. Let's say I want to make it dashed line, close. So you see that all these have become dashed line. This is maybe a better representation, and you can fill in all the data. So you can say that how the values are working. So you can move it into a new sheet also. Let's say you can move it into a new sheet and see how they are performing. Right? So this is an example of stack column. A stack column is being used when you have for a particular. So it has to be used for group data. Okay. And when that group data is summing to 100% over the years, if they are coming, you should use this type of stack column chart. Idea is that they should be 100%. Right?